Good afternoon and welcome to Munich. It's day three of the ISSF World Cup as we sweep over the hotel here and the finals hall. This was the venue of the 1972 Munich Olympic Games. It's also been host to plenty of World Cups since 1986. Good afternoon. My name is Rory McAllister. I'm your commentator this afternoon and delighted to say my guest is Jackie Herbold from Germany. Hello.
Hello, Rory.
Now, Jackie, you're the customs manager for the German Shooting Federation. That's actually quite an important job, making sure that all the pistols and rifles and all get in and out of customs whenever the shooters are travelling around the world.
That's true.
So you're a bit of a linchpin of the team, really.
That's also true, yeah.
Well, it's lovely to have you here this afternoon.
Thanks for having me.
For this 10-metre air rifle men's final. So we're just going to hand over to Jamie Stangroom, our announcer for this afternoon, to introduce the athletes.
Ladies and gentlemen, the organising committee of the ISSF World Cup Munich 2018 and the International Shooting Sport Federation welcome you to the Olympic shooting range here in Munich. The final competition for the 10-metre air rifle men's event will now begin. So let's meet the athletes. On firing point A, representing Croatia, he's competed at three Olympic Games with three World Cup medals to his name, making his second Munich 2018 finals appearance, is Petar Gorsha.
Here's Petar Gorsha of Croatia in his second final of the week. Won the bronze at the World Cup in Gabalar, and this is his second appearance in a final of a World Cup in the 10-metre air rifle. Ilya Chargega of Bulgaria, only 25 years old. He was sixth in the Olympic final, an amazing achievement to make the final at the Olympics in Rio, and he won the silver at the World Cup in Munich 2012, and won a bronze here as well in 2013. Martin Strempfel of Austria, this is his first appearance in a final. He was 11th in Fort Benning back in 2011. He's also competed at Changwon, Belgrade, Sydney, Milan, all over the world. Now 33 years old. So looking very composed, away for the crowd, Vladimir Maslennikov of the Russian Federation, the world number two, took the gold medal at the World Cup in Rio in 2016. And has three silver medals to his name, most recently from Changwon last month in 2018. Also won a silver here in 2017 and also in 2015. Milenko Sabic of Serbia was sixth in the World Cup final in Changwon. That was in 2015. He's also competed in Fort Benning, Maribor, Munich, Rio. Again, been all over the world.
And this is his first ever final at a World Cup. Please welcome Lu Shao-Chuan.
So Lu Shao-Chuan of Chinese Taipei is only 21. And this is his first World Cup final. Or appearance in a final at a World Cup, should I say. Did win a silver in New Delhi in 2015 at the Asian Championships. So he does already have some silverware. Sergey Kamenskiy of the Russian Federation already got a silver medal from this week in the three positions. And also took gold at the Munich World Cup in 2017 and a bronze at Rio in 2016 at the World Cups. Patrick Jani of Slovakia. Again, a young man, 20 years old, and this is his first appearance in a final of a World Cup.
And our chief range officer for this final is Mr. Uwe Folks of Germany.
Says Uwe Folks, the chief range officer for this final. It's a nice day outside, it's in the mid-20s. It's been lovely, actually, for most of the time of our trip here to Munich. Only thing is, it's just that where we are in the commentary position, we're right by the window, which almost feels like we're sitting in a greenhouse at times. So I hope you're as comfortable as possible, Jackie. And my guest this afternoon is Jackie Herbold of the German Shooting Federation. And we're just about to get underway with this 10-metre air rifle men's final here on day three of the ISSF World Cup here in Munich. So Jackie, enjoyed the World Cup so far? You've also been doing the medal ceremonies?
Yeah, for sure. It's pretty nice meeting old friends, making new friends every time. Pretty nice to be here.
Now, one thing I have noticed is that you seem to know everyone.
Kind of, yeah. I'm here since 4 years. I also were at some world championships, and so yeah, you see the same faces.
And everyone seems to know you as well.
That could be.
Okay, so if you had to pick a winner now from the final.
Yeah, I will say Milenko, to be true. Yeah.
Okay. Let's see what happens then, shall we? This is shooting. Literally anything can happen and has been happening this week. I mean, it's been an intriguing World Cup so far. So the crowd here are gathered at Munich. Again, most of them standing. They really do know they're shooting here in Munich. It's a real concentrated hive of shooting knowledge and ability as well. So much history here as well. The 1972 Munich Olympics was held here. And also, there's been no fewer than about 28 World Cups since 1986. I'm not even sure you were around in 1986, though, Jackie. I might have been a mere eight, but I was. So we're just about to get underway. So Milenko Savic is Jackie's tip for a gold today as we get underway with this final this afternoon. It's just gone 1:15 local time here in Germany, but wherever you are around the world, then good afternoon and welcome. This is ISSF TV. It's very nice to have you here. Here's Petr Gorsha in his second final of the week. And Milenko Savic opens up with a 10.8. Not
Seems
a bad
like
start,
the best
Jackie.
Shot.
So any of the shooters in today's final, do you know these guys personally?
I know Milenko. We were talking yesterday. And I also know Sergey Kamenskiy. But the rest, actually, I just know from seeing them walking around here, saying hello.
And here is Kamenskiy. Already has a silver medal from this week. He's a nice chap.
Oh, he's a really nice guy. I like to talk to him. It's always funny.
So far, some fairly high scores. Again, the atmosphere in the finals hall today is pretty tense. It's pretty warm too. I said it's hot outside and the heat has been coming into the finals hall here, and there's even some mild sweat from the spectators, who I think are feeling the nerves just as much as our athletes this afternoon. Here's Vladimir Maslennikov. So this is our only final of this afternoon. And if you have just joined us, this is the 10-metre air rifle men's final on day three of the ISSF World Cup in Munich. Here's Patrick Jani of Slovakia. Just making a few adjustments there. And the chief range officer has called stop. So there you go, Jackie, what do you think so far?
Oh, they're pretty strong shots. And Malenko strong as always. Also good shots from Kamenskiy, very high scores. It's going to be interesting, I think.
Well, again, that is a high opening score. That's 52.8 from Savic of Serbia. Even Martin Strength in eighth position has a total of 50.7. So there is only a difference of 2.1 between Strength in eighth position and Savic in first. So here is Savic, the leader. There'll be another 5 shots per athlete. Then we'll go to single shots and have our first elimination after shot number 12. Here's Vladimir Maslennikov of Russia. Needs to improve slightly because 9.6s won't be enough to take anything here this afternoon. The competition is just too high.
But now there are a lot of strong shots from the Austrian guy, from Martin. He's getting back in the game.
And that's a 10.8 from Kamenskiy as well. I'm certainly thinking he'll be in the medal hunt as well this afternoon.
I also think so, yeah. Martin actually made a big jump to the medal positions.
That's right, Martin Strempfel was in eighth position, is now up to fourth. So the margins are pretty tight and anything can happen. This is Chargay of Bulgaria. Yeah, he gets frustrated there. A 9.6 is enough to make him sigh quite heavily. This is Lu Shao-Chuan of Chinese Taipei. It's so quiet in the finals hall today. The concentration not only from the athletes, but also from the coaches who are just a row behind. And also all the spectators. Which means that the spectators don't even need to be watching the live transmission because they can just hear what we're saying anyway. Stop. So chief range officer has called stop. So that's now 10 shots into this final. And Savic still leads on 104.1. Petagorsha of Croatia is in second position. There's still only a difference of 0.2. This is incredibly close, Jackie, already.
That's not much between them.
No, and Kamenskiy, there's only a difference of 0.5 as well. So
also Martin, he's just 0.1 behind Sergey.
Yeah, and has moved up from eighth position. It's now Patrick Jany in eighth position. We now move to the single shot section of the final. So this is shot 11. The chief range officer just given the commands, and it's so important that these shooters concentrate and follow each command just to avoid any warnings or any yellow cards. Or here's Milenko Savic, who's looking really focused.
That's true.
And a 10.1 from him.
Shoot wasn't that good.
No, he needs to be shooting higher than that, really, doesn't he, if he's going to carry on leading this competition. Although saying that, I mean, it's still an excellent shot, isn't it? Nonetheless. So, yes, the lowest shot, even a 10.0, that was from Jany through that last series of single shots. And it's Savic who still leads, again, with a narrow difference. There's only a difference of 0.1. That is incredible.
And just look at Kamenskiy. He's also just 0.3 points behind Peter Gosa.
And Martin Strength of Austria, only 0.1 behind Kamenskiy. I mean, it really couldn't be any closer. This is...
They're all really close.
And this is where the concentration really, really counts, because you've just absolutely got to keep up. You've really got to be on your A game.
That's true.
You've got to give it your best, because one slip up here.
Kamenskiy actually had a really bad shot now for this.
For this particular final, yes. I mean, a 9.9. It's not going to be enough. But we have our first elimination from this final. A huge cheer from the Slovakian team who are gathered here. I was chatting to them earlier. Very, very delightful they were as well. So Patrick Jany is eliminated from this final on a total of 121.9. So it's Savic of Serbia who still leads, with a narrow lead of 0.4 from Petar Gorsha of Croatia. And then Martin Strentful is now up to third position. That's a rise from eighth earlier on in this final. So Martin creeping into the medal positions for the moment. But obviously there's still a long way to go in this final. So some 817 shooters came to this World Cup, representing 84 Olympic countries. That's a big number, for over 1,500 starts, 1,512 starts. I mean, just incredible numbers. It's just great to see numbers like that, and a competition here in Munich, which is just so renowned for its shooting.
But just look at Kamenskiy.
Yeah, Kamenskiy is slipping down the scoreboard at the moment. He's down to seventh position, so in danger of elimination unless he can improve. He's 0.2 behind Maslennikov, his fellow countryman. So it's between the two Russians at the moment. And seventh place will be decided after this shot, unless there is a shoot-off. That's Eugenie Krainov, Russian coach. A very composed man, always looks very composed and focused. And
he looks really serious.
On the job, yes, yes. Has two of his shooters in this final. One of them may go. We don't know yet.
But a bad shot from Milenko. 9.7.
So seventh place has now been decided. So representing Austria, Martin Strenthal, who has moved around all over this scoreboard, starting out in eighth, was up to fourth at one point, and then even up to
third also.
To third as well, yes. And now leaves this final in seventh position. So this is just how it goes. If this is the first final you've ever witnessed in world shooting, then this is what happens. Martin at least has time to wave to the camera, which is very nice as he goes back, takes off his suit and takes his seat.
Also, Milenko changed from first position to third position because of his last shot.
And this is how this final's going, really, isn't it? It's literally almost one shot below a 10, and immediately you're moving around three or four places.
One shot can change everything.
Yeah. As we saw earlier in the week as well with Chandela of India, who was leading the competition. And
then she shot a 5.9,
right? 5.9, yeah. And just, that was it. Couldn't recover. I felt for her so much. So here's Lu Shao-Chuan of Chinese Taipei.
I got a good shot from Milenko again.
And Petr Gorsha as well has scored a 10.6. And
Ilya and has also a 10.7.
A 10.7, so again, some very high scores at this stage of the final. So Chargaya leads the competition at the moment, a difference of 0.2. Lu Shao-Chuan of Chinese Taipei is in second position, and Milenko Savic of Serbia, again, only just behind with a difference of 0.2 in third at the moment.
Now it's going to be interesting if Sergey Kamenskiy can make it to beat his teammate, or if he's going to be ruled out.
There's Eugenie Kronov looking on. I mean, Kamenskiy finds himself 1.2 behind Maslennikov.
That's going to be hard.
And this is where it really counts. You're literally shooting to save your place in the final.
Impossible.
And Kamenskiy has hit a 10.6. And Maslennikov has hit a 10.7. So it means that Sergey Kamenskiy, almost a surprise exit so early, if you like, in this final. I think he's disappointed as well as he walks away. He does wave to the crowd, but he leaves this competition in sixth position, and it's his second final of the week, although he does already have some silverware from this week. He walked away with a silver medal already.
But I really thought that he's getting another medal.
I would have said so myself at the beginning of this final, but we're now down to five athletes, almost getting to the business end, if you like, of this final. Maslennikov and Gorsha on joint fourth, both on 165.6. Milenko Savic in third, Ilya Chargaya in second, and it's now Lu Shao-Chuan of Chinese Taipei who leads this competition by the narrowest of margins, only by 0.1. The crowd here at Munich are now starting to get behind the athletes, clapping along. A 10.4 from Chargaya. Let's see what Lu shoots now. Here he is. And a 9.9, which means literally from first down to joint third position for Lu Shao-Chuan, literally on one shot. This is so incredibly close. So Chargaya leads again, Jackie.
That's true. And Milenko is now the last place. That's how it goes.
So we now have our next elimination shot. So Milenko-Savic has scored a 10.3, which was one of the lowest scores over the last single shot, and it's just not enough to stay in this final. So representing Serbia, Milenko-Savic leaves without a medal in fifth position in this final. Now, how close would you like it now going into the last four athletes? We have Gorsha and Lu Shao-Chen joint in third position on 186.4. And then a 0.1 in front is Maslennikov of Russia. And then another difference of 0.1. So there is 0.2 between Lu Shao-Chen and Petr Gorsha and Ilya Chargaya.
That's unbelievable.
This is the closest final we've seen this week. So if you have just joined us here at ISSF TV, you've joined at exactly the right time. It's just gone 1:30 local time here in Munich. It's day three of the ISSF World Cup. Here is Petr Gorsha. Now, every single athlete now involved in this final of the last four knows that they literally now have to hit their best shot.
This is going to be really, really interesting now.
So a 10.2 from Maslennikov. A 10.2 from Chargaya and a 10.9 from Gorsha shoots him up into the lead. Incredible.
What an incredible shot.
At this stage of the final as well, it literally is just changing all the time. So Petr Gorsha of Croatia now leads 197.3. I think there'll be a massive round of applause should he manage to stay in that position and take a gold medal today. I couldn't call this now. This is going to go either way. Start. Here's Maslennikov. He's shooting to keep himself in this final. He's only 0.1 behind Lu Shao-Chen and Chargaya. So it's the narrowest of margins. This could be so cruel. This is a difference of winning a medal or not. And Maslennikov has hit a very, very solid shot. 10.6. A 9.6 this time from Gorsha, so he's gone from 10.9 to 9.6. And Chargaya, a 10.7. And an ooh from the crowd with Lu Shao-Chen, a 10.1. So there is a tie.
And now it's a shoot-off.
Between Lu Shao-Chen and Petr Gorsha. Petr Gorsha, who was leading this competition, but a 9.6 just hasn't been enough. So they are tied on 206.9. We have the first shoot-off of this final. Here we go. Everyone's feeling this. There's some murmuring around amongst the crowd now as the clapping continues.
Oh.
So Lu Shao-Chen to shoot now. And there's whooping from the crowd. The applause goes up into the air. Lu Shao-Chen survives, so there will be a medal. Another medal for Chinese Taipei. Just depends what colour. But leaving this competition, and he led just ever so slightly. Representing Croatia, Petr Gorsha leaves in fourth position, missing out on a medal when it went down to the shoot-off.
He looks really disappointed.
He does. Yeah, and he looks annoyed with himself too. So the bronze medal he won in Gabalar at the World Cup, and this being his second appearance in a final at a World Cup, and he leaves pretty much empty-handed because there's no medal. So we're down to the final three now. This is to decide the medals. 206.9 for Lu of Chinese Taipei. He's 0.4 behind Maslennikov. And then Maslennikov is only 0.2 in front, so...
They're so close. Oh, but strong shot.
10.7. Very, very impressive at this time in the competition. He's only 21 years old to have that composure. I don't even think Gary Anderson there, the ISSF vice president, can believe it.
just look how close they are now. Unbelievable.
So after all this, we've had 22 shots in this final, and this is how close they are. So to decide the bronze medal.
Everything can happen now.
Stop. Eugenie Krenov, the coach of Vladimir Maslennikov. You can see him just saying, look, just hang on in there. Give it your best. He does look really focused. Let's see what he comes up with here. And a 10.3 from Liu Shao-Chen as well. So there was a 0.4 difference between the two athletes, but it's another medal for Chinese Taipei. It's their second medal of this week. It's a bronze, and it goes to Liu Shao-Chuan. He's won a medal before, won a silver medal at the Asian Championships in New Delhi 3 years ago, and he's still only 21 years old. So who knows, that could be his first World Cup medal of many. One to watch, I'm sure. So here we go to decide the gold and silver medals. There's a difference of 0.7 between Maslennikov of the Russian Federation and Sergey of Bulgaria. This scoreboard has pretty much been changing all the way through this final, except now until the final stages. Are you going to call this, Jackie?
I'm just so nervous. I have no idea who's going to make this now. Really strong shot from Ilya.
He's increased his lead. It could be enough as well. It's looking like it's going to be. So there's a difference. 238.1, 239.4. That's what separates Chargea and Maslennikov.
And just remember how close it was. Just two shots ago.
This is it. And a difference of 1.3, though, on the final shot. I mean,
that's a lot.
Yeah, something's going to have to go drastically wrong here for Chargea.
But never say never.
But exactly, never say never, as we witnessed earlier on this week. Stop. 10.1 and a 10.7 from Maslennikov. Yes, he closed the gap, but he had a gap of 1.3 to make up. So Belarus have their first medal of this World Cup, and it's Ilya Chargea of Belarus who takes the gold medal. He was sixth in the Olympic final. He also won a silver at the World Cup in Munich 2012 and a bronze here in Munich in 2013. So chalk that one up. That's now a gold medal in 2018. That's not a bad record so far. And Vladimir Maslennikov wins the silver medal. So Chinese Taipei have their second medal. They've already got a gold. They now have a bronze medal as well. That's Liu Shao-Chen, the 21-year-old. The silver medal going to the Russian Federation, Vladimir Maslennikov. And the gold medal. What a performance. I mean, he really, really, he punches the air, and rightly so, because that was composure.
Was fighting for it.
Literally, he did fight for it. Ilya Chargea of Belarus wins the gold medal in this final. The only final for today, the 10-meter air rifle men's final. So if you have just joined us, it's just over. If you're watching it back on Facebook, then we hope you enjoyed it. Feel free to leave your comments. So for myself, Rory McAllister, and my guest this afternoon, Jackie Herbold. Thank you very much, Jackie. It was great to have you here.
Thanks.
From everyone here at ISSF TV, we'll see you for day four tomorrow. But for now, it's goodbye. Thank you.
The bronze medal representing Chinese Taipei goes to Lu Shao-Chuan. The silver medal representing the Russian Federation goes to Vladimir Maslennikov. And the gold medal representing Belarus goes to Ilya Chaminga. Ladies and gentlemen, please rise for the national anthem of Belarus. Gentlemen, one last time, let's congratulate the winners of the 10-meter air rifle men's event. One more time, give it up for Lu Shao-Chuan, Vladimir Maslennikov, and our gold medal winner, Ilya Chaminga.